cash statements, and how it links to other statements. The balance sheet tells us what a company owns and owes. The income statement tells us what a company earns and pays over the specific time span. The cash statement uses all of that information and explains where the actual money is in all that process. When thinking about the cash statement, it is important to recall the definition of accrual accounting. Essentially, when the revenue is earned and not yet claimed, the revenue is recorded both in the income statement as revenue and on the balance sheet as receivables, but not cash. At the first sight, it feels reasonable to think that we had revenue, we must have more cash. Is that so? Not exactly. The cash has not been impacted yet, and frankly, the increase in receivables results into a negative cash flow as we are using cash we have to finance the delay in receiving cash at some point in the future. There are three parts of the cash statements: cash flows from operations, cash flows from investing, and cash flows from financing that we are going to look in more detail in the next sections. Cash statements and how it links to other statements. The balance sheet tells us what a company owns and owes. The income statement tells us what a company earns and pays over the specific time span. The cash statement uses all of that information and explains where the actual money is in all that process. When thinking about the cash statement, it is important to recall the definition of accrual accounting. Essentially, when the revenue is earned and not yet claimed, the revenue is recorded both in the income statement as revenue and on the balance sheet as receivables, but not cash. At the first sight, it feels reasonable to think that we had revenue, we must have more cash. Is that so? Not exactly. The cash has not been impacted yet, and frankly, the increase in receivables results into a negative cash flow as we are using cash we have to finance the delay in receiving cash at some point in the future. There are three parts of the cash statements: cash flows from operations, cash flows from investing, and cash flows from financing that we are going to look in more detail in the next sections. Cash flows from operations. The operational cash is the cash that we have received as we have been operating the business, and it all starts with the net income. We then subtract and add items that have impacted the use of cash. The formula I'm going to tell you now has three different items that are required for the calculation. So cash flow from operations equals net income plus non-cash items, plus changes in the working capital. While there is not much to highlight in respect to net income, other two items do require additional discussion. The non-cash items include the items that are the expenses that affect the assets rather than cash. Examples of such items are depreciation and amortization, unrealized gains and losses, impairment, and asset write-downs, stock-based compensation, provision for discount expenses and future losses, and deferred taxes. Changes in working capital are based on the changes in inventories, accounts payable, accounts receivable, accrued expenses, and unearned revenues. As explained earlier, the increase in receivables would be an example of use of cash. Equivalently, the decrease in receivables would lead to increase in cash. And similarly, the increase in inventories would use the cash, while decrease in inventories would lead to freeing up some of that cash. cash flows from financing. The financing part explains how the company is receiving or spending its cash based on the interaction with its investors, either equity or bondholders. The items here are directly linked to the items located on the right side of the balance sheet, specifically liabilities and owner's equities. And there is a special formula that is applied for the calculation of this cash flow section. So cash flow from financing equals issue or repurchase of equity plus issue or repurchase of debt plus dividend payments or other items. Cash flows from financing. The financing part explains how the company is receiving or spending its cash based on the interaction with its investors, either equity or bondholders. The items here are directly linked to the items located on the right side of the balance sheet, specifically liabilities and owner's equities. And there is a special formula that is applied for the calculation of this cash flow section. So cash flow from financing equals issue or repurchase of equity plus issue or repurchase of debt plus dividend payments or other items.